I want to welcome you this week to week 18 in a study in 2 Corinthians. You know, we've been in this study for a long time, 18 weeks in 2 Corinthians, but we went through so much more in 1 Corinthians and Romans. We spent 41 weeks in an in-hymn scripture study, and this is where we've ended up. We're right now in chapter 9 of 2 Corinthians, and I want to encourage you to go back to June the 21st of 2021 and start this in him scripture study with us. You know, that's where we started it at. And then we went into Romans, 1 Corinthians, and 2 Corinthians. And the Lord has led us into a teaching on giving into the kingdom of God, and what Paul taught the Corinthians on what to do, how to do it, and to follow through with their giving. I've been talking about this for the last few weeks, and we've never really talked a whole lot about giving on this podcast, but through the years, the Lord has shown me so much about what He wants for me and for every other born-again Christian to come to understand, that the world needs what He's got. And that is, the world needs His Word. And it takes funds to put His Word out and to sow His Word into the world that we live in. It is so important that people come to realize the love and the mercy and the grace and the goodness that God has for them. Because a lot of people, the majority of people in the world that we live in today, have never really saw God's love. They've saw religion and what religion has made God out to be, but they've never saw and understand that just the depth and how much God loves them and cares about them. There's something about people that come to the realization, come to the revelation of who they are in Christ Jesus and what it'll do in their life. It'll set them free from all the shame and the condemnation and the junk out here in this world that just weighs us down. This is way I talked about this the other night at church. We do that in him scripture study, these videos that go into the prisons and the jails, and I talked about it, getting a revelation of what God thinks about you, how much God thinks about you. And when you come to the realization of that in your heart and in your mind, and have your mind renewed to the truth in God's Word and how much He loves you and He cares for you and wants more than anything in the world to see you know it, I'm telling you, there's freedom there that you will not find in anything in this world. Freedom in Him. Freedom in Christ Jesus. I had two ladies that come over here and stayed a week with us one time and camped in our field. And they spent the whole week going through a bunch of rituals, law rituals, for the Old Testament rituals. There's nothing wrong with that. They enjoyed themselves doing it. But I got to talking to them, told them about the podcast, and told them to let their pastor know I'd be glad to talk to him about it. And they asked me a question. They said, how did you find your freedom? I told them, I said, listen, I said, I found freedom in Him. I found out who He had said I was. And that when I found out who He had made me to be through the promises of God's Word, it changed my life and it'll change yours. So I'm going to encourage you today. Find out what the Word of God says to you, for you, and about you, because it'll change your life like you've never had it changed before. Salvation will be that much sweeter when you find out what God says to you, for you, and about you in His Word. Once again, I want to bring you my prayers for the world that we live in. Every person that walks the face of this earth, I pray that they come to understand what Paul wanted the Ephesians to understand, have their spiritual eyes open, and have the wisdom to understand just how much God loves them. Ephesians 1:15 says, "Ever since I first heard of your strong faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for God's people everywhere, I have not stopped thanking God for you. I pray for you constantly, asking God, the glorious Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, to give you spiritual wisdom and insight so that you might grow in your knowledge of God. I pray that your hearts will be flooded with light so that you can understand the confident hope He has given to those He called, His holy people, who are His rich and glorious inheritance. I also pray that you will understand the incredible greatness of God's power for us who believe Him. This is the same mighty power that raised Christ from the dead and seated Him in the place of honor at God's right hand in the heavenly realms. Now He is far above any ruler or authority or power or a leader or anything else, not only in this world, but also in the world to come. God has put all things under the authority of Christ and has made Him head over all things for the benefit of the church. And the church is His body. It is made full and complete by Christ, who fills all things everywhere with Himself." Ephesians 3:14 says, "When I think of all this, I fall to my knees and pray to the Father, the Creator of everything in heaven and on earth. I pray that from His glorious, unlimited resources, He will empower you with inner strength through His Spirit. Then Christ will make His home in your hearts as you trust in Him. Your roots will grow down into God's love and keep you strong. And may you have the power to understand, as all God's people should, how wide, how long, how high, and how deep His love is. May you experience the love of Christ, though it is too great to understand fully. Then you will be made complete with all the fullness of life and power that comes from God. Now all glory to God, who is able, through His mighty power at work within us, to accomplish infinitely more than we might ask or think. Glory to Him in the church and in Christ Jesus through all generations, forever and ever. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen." I thank God He's opened my eyes to that love. He opens it more and more every day of my life, and He does it through His Word. Glory to God. Let's see what God's Word has to say today. Father, I thank You and I praise You, God, for Your Word. Guide me. Use me for Your honor and Your glory. Help me be the light and the vessel, Lord, that You can speak through, that You can shine through today. And I'll forever give You all the praise and glory for it all. In Jesus' holy name I pray. Amen. Now, we've been talking for weeks now about giving. And I want to change up a little bit. Today, we're going to talk about all things supplied. You know, the Bible talks about, you know, that God gives seed to the sower. The ones that want to sow into His kingdom, He will always make sure that you've got seed to sow into His kingdom, to give into His work. Let me read this. It says, this is 2 Corinthians 9, chapter 9 and 8 in the King James Version. It says, "And God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that you always, having all sufficiency in all things, may abound in every good work." Now, that's kind of vague if you're not familiar with this scripture, this passage of scripture. But I want to tell you, I want to read this in the New Living Translation. It says, "And God will," this is 2 Corinthians 9 and 8 in the New Living Translation. It says, "And God will generously provide all you need then you will always have everything you need and plenty left over to share with others." He said, what are we talking about in this whole chapter? Giving. He said, look, if you'll give, I'll make sure that all your needs are met. He said, I'll make sure that everything you're trying to do, needing to do, He said, I'll make sure you got that and plenty more left over so that you can give to somebody in need. That's what we're put here for. And that to be blessed by God, and to be a blessing in that being blessed. You follow me? Let me read the Amplified Classic. It says, and God is able. Now, I want you to go back and read 2 Corinthians 9 and 8. This is the Amplified Classic version of it. It says, God is able to make all grace, every favor, and earthly blessing come to you in abundance, so that you may always and under all circumstances and whatever the need be, self-sufficient, possessing enough to require no aid or support, and furnished in abundance for every good work and charitable donation. This is just right down the line of what we have been made, or what we have been talking about in the last few weeks. Paul said it. He said, hey, you know, what was he doing? He was taking up money to help the brothers, his family, the Jewish people in Jerusalem. He was doing his best to reach out to them and take them what they needed to survive. I mean, they were really in a bad way. And God is saying in no uncertain terms in this passage of scripture through Paul, he said, look, he said, I'm going to make sure that your needs are met and you've got plenty more, so that you can give to things like this, so that you can give to the working of helping others do and live the way you're living. See, there's a lot of people in this world that are in dire need, that are in dire need of something. I talked about it yesterday. You know, this America is not, there's not a food shortage in America. Yes, there's food shortages out in the world. And like I say, I'm all for digging water wells. I've put my money through where my mouth is. I give to stuff like that. I give. If there's one thing I've done in the last 10 years of my life, that is to give faithfully to organizations and to this ministry itself, to get out here and give food away on the street right here in Cleveland, Tennessee. This ministry has been a part of that for years and years. But this is not the biggest need in the world we live in today. Food is not the biggest need that we see in the world today. What is the biggest need? I'm going to promise you something. Knowing where you stand with God is the biggest need, whether it be for salvation or whether it be you're born again and you just have no idea where you stand with Him, because you don't know who that salvation has made you to be in Christ Jesus. I'm satisfied of it. If you can help someone find out who they are, you'll help someone change somebody else's life. Because when you come to the point, when you have that revelation, I sent this man a message earlier this morning and told him, I said, when you have the revelation of who Jesus Christ has made you to be, it'll change you. It will change you. I told him just how to get this podcast and what he needed to do to download the phone app, the whole nine yards. Know him personally. And this is something that people need to know and realize, that Jesus Christ died to make them a whole lot more than they're living in. This world is full of religion. Religion says you have to work. You have to toil. You have to be in a strain the biggest part of your time on this earth. But God's grace didn't say that. He didn't say that here. He said, and Paul said it, God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that you always having all sufficiency. In other words, everything supplied for you in all things. And may that you may abound to every good work. In other words, everything supplied for your need and things left over so that you can give and help somebody else. That's what the church is for. I'm not going to get off into politics or nothing like that, but this church, the church of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, us as a body, as God's God's church here on this earth. We are the body of Christ. We are the church. And we are used in this earth today to help people and lift them up and to see people's lives changed. The head, which is Christ Jesus, is not going to get out here and talk to people on the side of the road, at Walmart, whether you're in jail or prison or anything like that. That's our job. That's our job. We have to put feet on what we see God telling us to do. And without us going, things won't get done. All things supplied. And the majority of the church has been convinced that, oh, you just need to live just as poor and downtrodden and beat down for the rest of your days so that you can be humble before God. God don't need your false humility, and that's what that is. God needs people strong, not in their self, but in Him, believing that if they give, it is given unto them. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom. Why? So that you can help somebody else. All sufficiency. I feel like I need to read this Amplified Classic version of this again. 2 Corinthians 9 and 8. In the Amplified Classic, it says, God is able to make all grace, every favor, and earthly blessing come to you in abundance. He's able to do all these earthly blessings. And so they'll come to you in abundance, so that you may always and under all circumstances and whatever the need be, self-sufficient, possessing enough to require no aid or support, and furnished in abundance for every good work and charitable donation. He said God's going to supply all your needs, but He's going to supply you more than your needs. He's going to supply you with enough. He will supply you with enough to give unto other stuff. And you say, well, how's He going to do that? Well, we've been talking about it, giving, talking about Mark 10:29-30, that no man has given up anything in this earth for Jesus and the gospel's sake, that God will not give him 100-fold return in this life. Give it back 100-fold return in this life. And what this is all geared towards is not for us to hoard it, not for us to put it in the bank and sit back and say, oh, I've got all this and I'm going to keep it. No, it's given unto us so that we can be a distributorship out here in the world and help others see where we're coming from, that we're not some religious organization that looks down our nose at you because you don't stand where we stand. No, we're here to help. We're here to reach out to you and help you, not to urge you to come into us and give to our thing. No, we talked about it yesterday, being a cheerful giver. No, we want you to be a cheerful giver to sow into God's kingdom so that others' needs would be supplied just like yours is. Giving is a way of life. Giving into the kingdom of God is a way of life. And I want to urge you to do that today. But before that, I want you to listen to me today. I'm going to ask a question. Are you born again? Do you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? You know, we've been talking about giving, and anybody can give. They can give into the kingdom of God. But I'm going to tell you something. No matter how much you give to the kingdom of God, if you're not born again, it don't merit you anything. I want to invite you today to do the only thing that will ever save you, and that is to make Jesus Lord of your life. Invite Him in. I'm not asking you if you believe in God. I'm not asking you if you've asked Him to forgive you 10,000 times. I'm asking you, have you ever made Jesus Lord? Jesus said, or Paul said it in Romans 10:9-10. The Holy Spirit spoke through Paul It said, thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and thou shalt believe in thine heart that God has raised him from the dead. It says, thou shalt be saved. It don't say you might be if you're good enough. It says you'll be saved if you'll confess Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead. It says, for with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. That's all it takes to be born again. If that's all it takes to be saved today. Won't you be saved today? Won't you be born into the family of God and allow God's word to come into your heart and into your life and change you? I'm going to tell you something. Jesus Christ will change you today. He is the word. The Bible says it. He said, the word became flesh and dwelt among us. God, if you want to hear from God, get in his word. Believe what his word says and stand on it. But most of all, make Jesus Christ Lord of your life today. Glory to God. Hey, I'm going to tell you something today. You cannot outgive God. Go to our website. Everything we've got on that website is free. Don't cost you nothing. And I'm not trying to coax you into giving. We've been giving this stuff away for years now. And I'm going to tell you something. It's free. It'll always be free. You can download anything you want off this podcast. It is free. YouTube channel, Facebook, Twitter, everything we put out on those social media platforms is free. All you got to do is download it. So go to our website. It's the-prodigalson.com. Now, if you're a partner of this ministry, partners, I pray a hundredfold return over everything that you sow into this ministry. Mark 10:29 guarantees us a hundredfold return over anything that we have given up for the gospel's sake, for Jesus' sake. And I thank God every day and praise him for the hundredfold return over everything that we give into his kingdom. Glory to God. If you're not a partner, pray about becoming a partner. Pray about what God would have you to do to sow into his kingdom today. Go to our website. Get in touch with us. It's the-prodigalson.com.